Hello, Aquarius. This is monthly forecast for you for the month of May 2017. A lot of cards this time. I wanted to do it this way. Let's start with work. Work, business, and things that you do for a living. In atmosphere of the month, in most important events, here is King of Swords. People around you, co-workers, clients, maybe even leadership, I don't know, but somebody, not you, somebody at work, Nine of Swords, and you, your behavior, how you dealing with things, Major Arcana Justice. For me, it looks like it's really not bad month, but there is some serious things that you have to do. And you know it, and you know how to deal with this. In your head, there is order there. You understand rules, you understand how, when, and what you should do. But somebody around you, I don't know, it's look like panic, like fears, person or people, maybe group of people, they are in stress. And I think that their behavior, their words, that they will be shaking there, they will be like bothering you this month. If it will be really difficult for you to concentrate at work, to concentrate on what you have to do, on papers, and things that you should do, if something in atmosphere always making you simply sick. You must not sacrifice your important things. You must not give up just because somebody hysterical around you. You have to try to find a place where you can concentrate on things that you're doing. Like, try to isolate yourself where you have a calm atmosphere, where silence and where you can work actually, where you can do your work that you're doing, you will be doing perfectly. You just need this space where nobody getting on your nerves. For some of you, maybe even to take your work home if it's a really impossible atmosphere at work. Noise, somebody getting fired and they are always in this fear, they are in stress. So keep in mind, try to find quiet, still corner or place or somewhere where you can work. Finances for you, Aquarius, this month look like Nine of Pentacles. It's really, I love this deck. For one thing, usually in traditional tarot deck, you remember this Nine of Pentacles. She's staying there in beautiful clothes, in her perfect garden, and it looks like she never has been working, actually. In this card, it's shown very well that, but the meaning of that Nine of Pentacles, the same, that person have been working a lot to achieve what she has now. If you Aquarius male, he, it's just because it's a woman on the picture. So this person have been working a lot and did a lot of work, tried and did a great job. And now this success, it's deserved success actually. So for finances, Nine of Pentacles, it's card of abundance, card of good money and even extra money, more than you thought you will make this month. So Nine of Pentacles, it's a good position financially. So your budget, you will be feeling well, you will be feeling sure. But you will be knowing what you've got this money for. It's a good thing. For home, for people who married, who are in the relationships, who living as a couple, strange things they're showing me. Atmosphere of your month in your family life, in your partnership. Six of Swords. And Six of Swords quite often, even in traditional deck, showing moving from trouble waters to calm waters, moving from some conflict zone to peaceful zone. And here the same, actually, if you can see. This girl running from the zone where, I don't know, some garbage, it's dark sky, it's so dirty there, it's unpleasant. Atmosphere there. She is running from that place to somewhere where is a green grass, sun is shining, everything is beautiful and wonderful, and she's so happy. So, changes, positive changes. You're moving from some difficult times probably in your relationships, or some problems that you had recently in your partnership, in your family. Maybe it's not between you and your partner, maybe it's some difficulties you had with some relatives. But this month, things getting better. Things are changing for good. But Six of Swords also symbolize going somewhere, moving from apartment to summer house, for example, or moving from one city to another, or from one house to another. Any change, change road, and this, any transition actually, of any kind, this month. So, good changes, positive changes for you. But, and what is your partner, or what you will be dealing with, what will be going on in your family, in your house? Four of Wands, it's excellent card. People preparing their garden for Halloween, actually, on this card. So, some of you, maybe you taking care of your garden, taking care of your house. Maybe there is some celebration, like somebody's birthdays. Not yours, because you are Aquarius, as I am, so we already had it. Maybe some birthdays of your kids, partners, parents, some other relatives, maybe somebody's marriage. So there is some good events. But what is wrong with you, Aquarius? Three of Swords. Maybe for some of you, because of work, because you can't get rest at work, because you are so, you're taking it so seriously, you're not allowing yourself to make any mistake at work, you're not allowing yourself to do anything stupid at work, and atmosphere really stressful, somebody around you like trying to make you to get you into stress zone. Maybe for home, even things are all right, you're not feeling well, you're not allowing it at work, but you might allow it at home. Keep it in mind, you must not do it. If you're so tired from your work, if you're really getting tired, if things are all right, if your wife and kids meeting you every evening and saying, wow, daddy is at home and daddy is not in the good mood, it's not a good thing to do. Maybe for some of you, because you have quite serious and responsible month at work, maybe you going somewhere, like a business trip. But at this moment, there is somebody's birthday or marriage or anniversary or something in your family, some nice event, but you can't be there. That's why you, like, your heart is broken. You going on this business trip, but at the same time, you feel like, I have to do it. I don't want to do it, but I have to. And that's why I don't feel well, actually. So for all of you, it will be different, but your condition is really like not the best one. You understand it, I hope. You must not suffer. Non-advice, the Hanged Man. Hanged Man, if you feeling some pain, if you're worrying about something, you must not suffer. You must not pay the victim of some circumstances. Hi, Aquarius. Advice for you, the Hermit. Hermit, it's philosopher. Someone who is really looking at things with a very wise, from the very wise point of view. Like, yes, sometimes things like that, they're happening. I'm not so happy about it. I can't jump and clap like, ah, it's so wonderful. Yes, I can't be happy, but sometimes life is like this. So try to see things from that point of view. And if you're isolated for some reason, instead from your family, at some interesting and important moment, you must not suffer from this. Take your time to do some of your work, read the books, maybe meditate a little bit. So, like, do something for yourself. Make yourself busy, or at least get some rest instead of worrying and crying. For your... I don't want to call this position health, actually. I would more say your emotional condition, your physical condition, how you will feel, actually. Because it's funny to talk about diseases and make a diagnostic of your health in general reading, don't you think? So, Eight of Wands, it's a wonderful card. It's a card of activity and processes that moving and going very fast in your body. So this great activity of something. So even if you will catch some cold in May for some reason, it should go away very fast. So some fast going processes. But if you active person, if you're doing some exercises, if you like to run, if you like to walk a lot, it's a great month. You will be really in good condition, physical condition, I mean. For single Aquarius, there is Ace of Chalices, card of love, card of falling in love, new love, meeting somebody. So you can fall in love, someone can fall in love with you. So it's card of joy, card of, I don't know, like possibility to fall in love on the first place. But I'm curious always, you know. I'm like this. And I asked cards, what will be, how this possibility will look like, what might happen later on. I'm always curious. And they showed me the Fool in reversed. So it's like, I have to find nice words in English. So I will not sound bad. It's difficult for me. I even don't know nice words for this. Ah, okay. Like, let's say, being too naive. Too naive. Like, completely, even if you're 50 years old, you will be like you're 8 years old. Honestly, being so naive that it's already even risky. It's dangerous for a person to be so naive. Fool in reverse, completely not thinking about consequences of what happening now and what will be in the future, what it might lead to. So it's really, really a lot of risk in this falling in love. And you have this hanged man in position, what is not recommended. And hanged man, it's also when we like diving in to this relationships, feelings, and we don't care what will happen, actually. So those cards, like, you see, meeting somebody, having like this feeling coming to our heart, we're so impressed, like we're losing our head and jumping into something without thinking what we're gonna do with this later. Because later, after this Fool in reverse, came Eight of Swords. And Eight of Swords symbolized that we are like, oops, feeling trapped. We don't know what to do with this thing. So I don't know what situation it might be. But you see the advice. We all wanna fall in love. We all wanna be happy. And you can be happy. And you should be happy, dear Aquarius. But I am begging you, please. When you will meet somebody and you will have this, you will be full of joy. You will want to jump into these relationships. Don't do it right away. Be a little bit like more cautious. Be attentive. Take your time. I know we don't like to do it. We prefer to have this feeling all over us. But I'm afraid with this hanged man in position of negative things that you might see in this person or in perspectives of this relationship something that is not possible there. It can be a risk that you will make some mistakes. That's why you have to be a little bit like more cautious and take your time. Don't jump into this like a crazy one. But anyways, I'm wishing you to fall in love and everything will be fine, I hope. But you must have your head. You have to be wise, I would say. So, dear Aquarius, I'm wishing you a wonderful month of May. Love, abundance, happiness, good mood. And hope to see you soon. Bye.